Welcome back to another episode of DomiNations with Domination Tips. I'm recording right after my last World War attack, which was quite ridiculous due to the complete destruction of the enemies, the enemy alliance, so that only the enemy number 24 was open and every enemy on top was quite killed. So now I'm recording what I'm quite doing nearly all midday or all afternoon between my World War attack, between my tutorials, between my guides for you and something like that. I'm just farming some around some millions of gold, food and trade goods to do my new upgrades, my researches in the base, and even to show you the things in the tutorials I want to show for you. But ordinary, here are no recording programs or cameras running, so that I cannot show it to you or emphasize how I am doing. And now with my Let's Farm project, I want to show you how and how long it is especially taking me to upgrade my walls and something like that. Because in the videos you are always only seeing my walls are getting bigger and bigger and higher and higher, and you don't see the progress within the walls when I have to farm it. You just see it when they are upgraded, and probably some of you asked yourself whether I'm paying real money, so real euros for my walls. And no, I can just easily show you I'm just not doing. I'm just nearly every afternoon, sometimes also at the evening in the multiplayer farming some millions. And so I have a target to upgrade one piece of a wall every day continuously. And I'm today also doing, but we have a special day because a new building or an upgrade, an old upgrade, is getting ready. The Alliance Gate upgrade, which cost me 9 days, I think. So I'm really looking forward to have more troop capacity for the next World War. In 6 hours, it would be ready automatically, just without crowns. But we have a little problem because currently our fight around England event is just running, and so our airstrip, our air defenses and the SAM batteries, which I have no access to because I'm not in the global age, are reduced by 40%. And so I want to take and use this event to upgrade my second out of my three air defenses to the max of industrial age. And therefore I need more citizens, and the event is only running for, let's see, oh, that was the false button. Sorry, now we are in the World War, I think. Which looks pretty amazing. Six stars to go, then we have the maximum capacity of 175 stars. But that I don't want to show it to you. I wanted to show you it's running until 14 o'clock UTC, and we have 11:30 UTC, so only 2.5 hours to go. But my Alliance Gate, which is my next building, which gets ready, needs 6 hours. So I have to speed it up. In the last 3 hours, I think with 50 crowns, and something around 50 crowns to get my citizens ready to use this fight around England event in the last seconds, on the last minutes, to get the savers, or even the event, whatever, the cost reduction of my air defense, then I can upgrade it. And so we are first farming some millions of gold because I want to upgrade another piece of the wall. But additionally, we are farming for one air defense. So let's see what we get earlier. I have trained my radar constellation, which I'm always using when I want to drop some medals and gain very, very fast resources. My record with this army constellation is about 8.5 million, I think, in 1 hour. I managed to get 1.5 million of gold, 8.5 million, sorry, of gold in 1 hour with this army constellation due to an event. There was a farming event where all caravans and the farms produced more gold and food. And during this event, with a training blessing like right now, I was able to get 8.5 million in 1 hour. Now I'm aiming only for gold. I have also not my food maxed out, but this will come automatically without that I have to focus on it. One bunch of gold is just missing. I hate this. because my aim is ordinary to not waste so many troops, and now I think I will let this bunch of gold over here to don't take it, because it would cost me some additional radars, but I want a really efficient relation between using troops and getting an amount of resources I wanted. So you don't have to take all resources which are available. Take the ones which are easily available without losing too many troops, so that you can fast retrain them during you are in the next battle. So my troops now will retrain during my time I'm searching for a new battle, and that's very efficient, so you can just immediately after the end of the last battle going right into the next one, scout the enemy whether there are some things you want to have. This one has 2000 of oil, nearly no gold, but some trade goods. No. Oh, wow. Some, yes, trade goods. And I want, one diamond. That was nice. Really nice. The oil is too good protected, and there is only 2000 of oil. So the troop losses I would gain attacking for this oil would be too high. Therefore, my aim was not on the gold with this player. By the way, I'm only farming the gold, the oil as my second most prioritized resource. My first prioritization is like nearly always on the gold, because I have currently nothing to do with my oil. I just can only wait, and when my triplane got researched in the blacksmith, I can decide whether to upgrade my triplane to the MK2. Or even probably when I have enough at this state to upgrade my tank to the heavy tank MK2. And I think I'm at 62,000, so only 18,000 to go, and I have nearly two days to go to get these amount of oil. And I think I will research my next MK2 stage of the heavy tank, because until now I could not use the heavy tank because it is so weak. My heavy tanks are so weak. But I have the Brandenburg Gate, and the Brandenburg Gate gives me 20% additional damage for my factory troops, and it would be a really waste to not use the factory troops. We have some resources, we have really nice resources over here, but some of them are spread in the command post and some of them in the markets and mills, and they are very in the middle of the base, very many defensive buildings around, so I would have to use all of my troops to get these resources, and at all this would be no efficient relation. Therefore I skipped this base. Also here, very good loot, very very good loot, but this guy designed his base very good. You see the gold, the markets are quite spread out, and so it's very unattractive for me to attack over here, because I would have huge troop losses and not even sure loot. Save loot. So sometimes you have to be very patient. It's not showing how big balls you have to attack someone, it's just being efficient, and that's what our aim is in this attacking style. Use the littlest amount of troops to get the most resources out. So now let's think about over here. I can place one. And over here. Oh, I hate this Singijeon. These Korean troops, they are killing my radar so fast in combination with the towers. Okay, this bunch of gold I don't want to take, because it's very good protected by these buildings. So I let it over here. 160,000 with 7 raiders, that means at least 25,000 gold per raider. That's not very good. The best efficiency is if you get more than 50,000 gold per raider. That's very efficient. Oh, my planes are dead, I see. Why are my planes dead and are not getting retrained? We have also one new alliance member. Additional guys, something I forgot to mention. This is unscripted content for you. Ordinary, I'm making a plan. I'm writing down what is my essential content I want to bring to you. And I also note down how I can bring it to you the most understandable way, so that you can use it the best way. But these Let's Farm episodes are just unscripted, so I have no plan, I made no plan how to show it to you. I'm just farming like I'm always doing and commenting it a little bit. Therefore, sometimes I have some breaks in it where I'm not commenting. Something will happen which I did not expect. Yes. Okay, there's also some gold in the bunches of gold. I did not expect this, but I have to go. It's not efficient anymore. There are, how long is my training blessing lasting? For 30 minutes only, and I have to speed it up in 2 hours. So I think the thing we will farm for is one piece of a wall for 4 million, and then one hour later I think I will go for the air defense. But I could also do it now. I see it in 2 hours. I forget to farm for the air defense, and then I will miss the end of the event. So I think when we have 3.3 million, I will just easily upgrade my air defense, and later on I will go for the wall. We have no event running for my walls, therefore the danger would be higher to miss the end of the air defense event, or whatever, fight around England. Yes, I think the biggest thing in looting is right about being patient. Here it's very, very great. You see an Enlightenment Age storehouse. Not very many gold, huge food, and like nearly everyone has his oil very protected, because you have only one oil building but three food and gold boil buildings, so it's so easy to protect your oil. Therefore, I think I will go for the enemy trade goods and hope that a diamond is in it. Fur, leather, wow, two times leather, two times fur, that was bad. One time leather only, wow. So you think there are always even some attacks of me which are really ridiculous, where I gain no efficient bonus. But that's life, so we will go on. And I can do some very helpful things. I can farm something for my base, for my walls, and simultaneously drop my medals, because I'm not winning at... Wow. They are too spread around. Here are some caravans, here are some caravans, but very many defensive buildings. It looks very nice, and indeed this is a very, very... okay, the loot is very okay, but... the efficiency of this attack would not be okay. What I wanted to tell you is I can simultaneously farm some loot for my base and also drop my medals, because my medal count was too high. I was at some more trade goods, and these trade goods are so unprotected that it's so easy to get them, guys, and therefore I always telling, don't put them so unprotected at the end of their war. Whoa, two diamonds for nothing. You see it, guys, that's very efficient, what I mean. Two diamonds with only one radar. That's how or why I'm always telling the guys in my lands, just don't put your storehouse, if you are not protecting it in your walls, just don't put it at the edge of your base, because it's so easy to rob it out with some troops. But at the other side, I'm profiting, or it's an advantage for me. All of the guys which are placing it such at the edge of their base, it's an advantage for me, so I'm really happy about this. Before I mentioned my medal count, when I'm too high, it's a medal count at 1400, 1500 medals. There are getting strong enemies, and the strong enemies, which are probably nearly equal to my base, are also protecting their resources very good, and then I'm losing very many of my troops to attack, and that's not any more efficient. Therefore, I'm dropping my medals to get down to some lower bases, even inactive bases, where I can farm really much easier, like even at this base, but there are even some weaker bases I'm aiming for, because you are not getting any prize for attacking high bases and showing some walls, but you are getting some advantages by having high walls and high upgrade buildings through effective farming. I'm really looking forward whether this Let's Farm project will interest you. So guys, if you are interested in this Let's Farm project, just let me know. Give me some, oh nice, give me some comments so that I can even do any more projects. Until now, I only did my Let's Farm projects in German, and the German subscribers were really interested in this project. Therefore, I did two episodes in German, and this is the first episode in English. If you want to see more episodes, give me some feedback down in the comment section. If there are enough viewers and enough feedback, positive feedback down in the comment section, I will do more English episodes of Let's Farm, of unscripted content. I have so many diamonds farmed. I will also upgrade my oil well blessing to get more oil from my wells, because that's very effective. I recognized. I always thought all of the producers like caravans and farms and something like that, and your oil wells, well or refinery, the oil wells. Okay, like the oil wells are very ineffective because they are producing only such a little amount of resources, but the oil wells, for example, are producing very, very much. The farms and caravans are only producing a very little amount, but if you are using this oil blessing over here, for nine hours, your oil wells will produce very much oil, and so I couldn't believe it, how fast my amount of oil grew. And I could upgrade some buildings I did even not plan, but I saw, okay, my oil grew that much. I was even not planning, but just let it upgrade. And so I think I will go next for my bunkers eventually, or even for my factory. I think I cannot upgrade it. Yes, it's maxed out. Otherwise, I would not have the tank. So let's get some cider. I think it's cider. I'm not quite sure what you are getting from the trees. We need three hundred thousand more of gold to get the air defense upgraded now. And then I have to think a little bit around. Oh, it's another spiral base. It's a little bit like my base, like my old base, but the mortars are placed very dumb. I have to make some thinkings about where to place my air defense when it's getting upgraded, because during the upgrade it's just worthless, like you probably know. So I'm just thinking about where can I place, or what can I replace my air defense with when it's getting upgraded. I think, let's see, I'm not quite sure. I will see. Let's get first an attractive loot enemy. This one is really attractive because he has placed all of his gold buildings right over there. Let's see. Oh, what are you going for, you idiot? Wow. He just wanted to crack off, or to get through this wall to get access to a redoubt. That's AI, artificial intelligence. Not thinking around. Oh, also another point, you can just not see what is inside a storehouse when it's getting upgraded. I know very many players which are using I don't know whether it's effective. It's a bug. When you are, like I told you, when you are upgrading your storehouse, then all of your available trade goods are just disappearing. So you just have them, but the enemy, when he is attacking, it's just not obvious for him. So I just cannot see. For me, this storehouse looks quite empty. But it could be that the storehouse is quite not empty. And I know some people which are very, very often and nearly always just clicking on upgrade their storehouse and then letting their storehouse upgrade, because they can just use it. But before the upgrade gets finished, they stop it, take it away, the upgrade, so that they only get the refunds or even half of the costs back. And then they are again upgrading their storehouse, so that nearly all the time enemy players cannot see what is in it. But it's just an optical bug. So, as you see, there are nevertheless some trade goods in it, but you just only can see them. So it looks like the storehouse would be quite empty, but it is not. So that's very stupid to place your all of your resources building like this guy did. Oh no. The oil, 500, 600 of oil, I'm not quite sure. Let's see whether here is some oil in. Yes, only a little bit, so I think we even will not get all of the... Don't go for the food, go for the oil. So I also think we will not get all of the gold, because some of his resources... Come on. Redoubts are very pain in the ass. Oh, wow. This trap cost me really much, really many of my raiders, so that's very ineffective, this attack. Fucking shit, let's get out of here. Wow, I lost 20 raiders, that was ineffective. What a crappy base layout, and nevertheless, I was so bad in attacking that I lost that much of my troops. So now we have to deal with this little amount of troops, which are remaining. 13, I have to do to use them wisely, to not waste all of them. Let's see. 300,000. No, they are quite spread around the base. No efficiency. The more you are dropping your metals, the more there will be some bases which are quite inactive. Some players which are not playing. And are here some diamonds? No. You see, some cider, metal, leather and fur are available, so I won't go for this town, for this storage house. I wanted to tell you, when you are getting down with your metal count, you will get some inactive bases where you can loot very, very easily. But the problem is, if you are getting too low, you will get to some guys which are just focusing the same like you. So if you are getting down below 400 metals, there will always only be the same guys like you which are going for a raiding, and they will always also raid you, and that's not very good, because then you are losing your trade goods and your resources you fight for, and these guys will also attack you like I'm attacking now, just only with raiders, and just then they will go away like I know, and I got a loss, so the enemy got no the enemy got the stars because the enemy won, I attacked, and but the enemy will get no peace treaty. So he lost some trade goods and even some of his resources. But the next attacker is just able to attack him right now, and that's very dangerous down there in this metal count, in this metal section. So don't go too low. For me, for example, 400 metals are the border. I'm not going below 400 medals, because then you are getting robbed very, very often, and that's even not efficient anymore. Again, no diamonds. The storehouse is really unprotected. Probably some traps over here, but I'm not caring for. But currently I have a very little amount of diamonds. Before I had very many diamonds, but we had a period in our world war history where we got very strong enemies, very strong, and there I had all the time to activate some coalitions, some war coalitions, and that cost me so much national trade goods and also my mercenary troops, and therefore I have to stock my trade goods, especially my cider and my diamonds up to get more flampanzers. I think this was quite an effective attack, guys. Let us see, we got with one troop 68,000. That was effective. Now we are also ready and able to upgrade, or I am ready to upgrade the air defense, and I will do so that my gold is away and cannot be stolen anymore if I get disconnected by some server problems or even by getting offline or whatever. I think I will upgrade. 83 crowns, it's okay. Let's speed it up. Wow, it looks very great. Looks quite modern. Okay, global age, 27 troops. Now I have 66 troops ready. I think I will first go for the stacks and for the beer. Also for the whatever. What is this for an animal? A pig or something like that. I will hunt it. And then I will upgrade this air defense. Come on. Please. So, 6 crowns. Nice. 6 crowns. And now I'm farming for the next piece of a wall. Oh, 2 over here. 2. 2. Okay, here will be the next piece of a wall. I will upgrade over here. Get this pick. I have also a reserve of 735,000 always available in my vault, because sometimes I get a very my timetable. Oh, 3 hours and is my forest ready. Another 3 people. I can just think about where to place them. I have an emergency reserve in my vault, because sometimes I have to get offline. I cannot farm anymore, and then I can use this reserve to get the last pieces of resources for an upgrade, so that I don't have to get offline with that much of resources. And also I have very many shippings or shiploads right across my base as emergency reserves. We will upgrade this one. Really nice. Get it outside of my base. I think I will place it. I have no gates right inside here, because you are only shooting buildings and my command post, and I don't want to get my Black Watch outside of this inner compartment, of this inner chamber. Therefore, I cannot place any gates in this wall, in this inner square. And I have to place another building which is not spawning any troops. Therefore, I think I will get this tower right inside, and this air defense outside for some additional hit points. So we have to wait 7 days, another week for this upgrade. It's all lasting so very long. Guys, there is another additional hind, and we see this hind, the atomic age will come. I got some really nice pictures right in my WhatsApp group. Here we are, guys. I searched it for you right in my WhatsApp group. Nexon published some very nice pictures about the atomic age. Atomic age approaches. APCs and helicopters. APC helicopter pilot Sean Whirlybird Martin describes his daring aerial assault. New wonders, the architecture firm of what? Cillan, Denham and KO built an atomic age skyline of tomorrow. State of war continues between the great nations of the world. We who have played war never stop playing it. General Brian DeSanti. Okay, that's a nice link to the developers. But we can see just some very nice troops over here. We can see the new bomber upgrade. We can see some APCs. I'm not quite sure what troops they will come for. Probably for the tanks. We see some barracks. Even the new level 8 mortars, I think. Some new tank depots. Markets, which are looking very... very futuristic. Even our what is it? Airstrip. Our airstrip, we can see some towers, the storehouse, a mill, and I think this is a world wonder, the Polytechnicum. I'm not quite sure how it's called. It's staying in Belgium, I think, and this will be one of the world wonders, I think. Probably even some new what is it called? Some new tactics, because we see some signs over here. I'm not quite sure. Probably it's a hind for some new tactics. And this is very interesting. Here we see some new tanks around. I have another picture, a screenshot for you. Come on. About the... can I show it? I think it's better this way. I'm not quite sure whether the YouTube channel will turn, the YouTube window. The Atomic Age approaches. In order to get you ready for this exciting new age, you will be running discount events covering the end of World War II. No matter which age you're in, you will be able to participate and earn rewards. The first of these amazing rewards starts with the Battle of Britain. event. Yes, this is running currently and it is ending in 30 minutes or 2 hours, I think, something like this. Between the fall of France and the entry of the United States and USSR into World War II, Britain stood virtually alone in opposition to Nazi Germany. The outnumbered British Royal Air Force heroically held off German Luftwaffe in a months-long air campaign, thus preventing an invasion of the Great Britain. Historians around the campaign fought entirely by air forces. These valiant soldiers gave their all to protect Queen and country. Prepare your empire for victory by checking back here often for new announcements and special blah blah blah. So you see, this is just only an announcement, but this over here is giving us some really nice information about the new age, I think. I think I will also use it as new wallpaper like this for this video, for this current video. And hopefully, probably some of you guys have even more information for me. If you have, just I would really appreciate if you would post it down there in the comment section. Some links or something like that. Here we are back. Oh, my troops are ready to train, already trained. We have 10 more minutes to go. Then we have 40 minutes of footage. I think this is enough for this first raiding episode of Let's Farm. Again, for those of you which have probably not heard my announcement, it would be really great to get some feedback from you whether this Let's Farm episodes are interesting or whether they are not, to see what I'm doing when I'm not recording ordinary to farm my walls and something like that. Wow, it's really hard to get to these bunches of gold because they are protected. No! Ah! I hate it if you click. Come on, please take the gold. Wow, very ineffective attack. So awful. I lost so much troops, only for 190,000. Wow. Not so good. When the next age is just approaching or getting revealed, I was currently thinking, okay, I'm coming nearly to the mid, even probably to the end of the industrial age, so that I can get to the next age, to the global, and then I thought for myself, okay, I'm finally in the last age, and now I can get something more big and defend myself. But now the next age is coming, and I'm even not at all maxed out in the industrial age, and that will took so much more time. And even the researchers in the global age and in the industrial age, for example, will get so much higher than they are right now. I think when the space age is coming out, the game will last, I don't know how long it will last. Even the university researchers are lasting so fucking long. If you want to do the stage 1 researches in the university, it takes 1 day, stage 2, 2 days, stage 3, 3 days, so even the last researches, the stage 10 researches, take 10 days. In total, that means you have to research for about 4 years. If you are not using any crowns. Wow. The developers of DomiNations do a very good job by making it attractive to use crowns to speed this very long processes up. But I'm only using anymore the crown amounts which I'm getting by the game itself. I'm not paying anymore for the crown reserves I have. I got 2,000 crowns by getting 1,000 stars in the World War for my alliance. Wow, here are all of the caravans just unprotected, but let us see. There's nearly nothing around, nothing in it. It's just all in the markets which are protected, not very bad. So we can just forget about it. We can just only go and take, wow, very many traps. Shit. I triggered all of his traps. That was very stupid. Then I will take your trade goods, my friend. Wow. I got one fur. One fur, that's really ridiculous. Therefore, your oil is mine. Wow. That was spooky. Yes, the oil was okay. We can take again an even closer look to the World War before we do our... Why don't I get any troops? I need more range distance troops, please. We can take another look at the World War, I wanted to say. The World War is quite awesome for you guys which have seen my video. This is out of our last 5 World Wars, this is the first one which is easy. All of the other ones was quite so hard that all of the enemy number 10 players which were stronger than our first best players. But now it's other way around. I only had to deal about... I'm in the middle of the industrial age and I only had to deal about a beginner of global age in relation to our other world wars where I nearly always had to deal about level 198 maxed out global age players. That was quite relaxing to attack this base. Nevertheless, this base is also not so bad. He's at the end of the industrial, probably at the end, not complete. There are some buildings missing, but the most interesting buildings like the tank depots and bunkers and something like that are in the industrial stage. And you can see 170 stars are the maximum capacity out of this world war because we have 35 participants and there was loot free, so everyone can choose a loot enemy and don't have to care for any more stars. But nevertheless, our players are caring for stars and now we have 172 out of 175 stars. So only 3 stars are remaining. One over here, then 2 over here. And pretty much 5 stars over here. When we look at the enemies, it's quite another picture. Only one of our best players got attacked. Here is enemy our number 5 player. Number 1, 2, 3 and 4 from us did not get attacked. All of the best enemy players attacked around our number 15, 15, 16, 17 down there. But the glory relation also shows this. We can win, I think, 23 glory. That's ridiculous. That's really the lowest amount we have ever had in a world war. 400,000, that looks very nice. But I don't know where the traps are, so we are only going for the outside market and for the nice oil. Wow, this oil is placed so awesome. Look at it, guys. I don't have any effort with getting it. There's just only one easy rider getting all of the oil. That's awesome. I love this. And I don't know why and how guys are placing their oil in this, right, like this one did. 1,300 oil, which he donated free to me. And I only got 30,000 of gold? Wow, that means all of the huge gold amounts were in the bunches of gold from the caravans. I did not got this point. That was bad of me. We are down at 974 medals. I think I will do another hour of loot. 3 hours? That must be a mistake. I will do another hour of farming to get down to 400 medals so that I can train my ordinary World War army again. I'm really bad, I have to tell you, I'm really bad in the current event, which Valhalla and... Wow! Really nice. Here I will use all of my troops. Because you see, here the markets and mills are completely nearly 100% empty. And there is nothing in, just everything inside the caravans and inside the farms. and a total amount of 500,000. That means that is quite an inactive player, I talk to you. This guy is inactive for a long, very, very long time. Wow, what was this? Oh, not for the house. Go for the gold, guys. That is nice. Where is some gold remaining? Oh, in the town center there will be some gold, I'm quite sure. Huh. Yes, there's very much gold inside the town center, you see. Wow, from the street. The street is industrial age maxed. And the street is also, like the caravans, just producing more and more gold, which is not getting getting from some enemies if they are not destroying the town center. There's one more bunch of gold. And then I think we got all of the gold resources from resources from this guy. Quite efficient. I think the last 48,000 are inside the markets. I don't want to get for them. Awesome loot, 560,000. I mean, I used very many troops, yes, indeed. But the loot is very okay. More than 500,000 of gold is very nice for one attack, only with raiders. Okay, the training blessing is away over here. So we will waste our actual troops and then the video is over. I think two, even probably three more attacks due to my efficiency in the next attacks. And then we are finished with this Let's Farm episode. Wow, maxed out walls. Freaky guy. Nevertheless, he got this just by playing. If you are that much active that you are able to farm your walls on stage 6 or 7, I think, you just don't go offline without any reason. If you are that much active, then you will go on playing. And this guy, yes, is not playing anymore. Thanks for your trade goods. Oh, no diamond. No diamond. There's some more oil? Oh yes, very many oil. Mm-hmm. Okay. So the last attack will follow now. Wow, that was not good, this attack. Only 300 of oil. I hoped for one diamond. But we did not get. Come on. Okay, last attack now. We farmed now. I talked very much to you, showed to you the world war, so we just only farmed about 3 million, I think. So if I would have done this more efficiently, there would be quite much more million of gold. Very much gold. I think I will go. I have only 5 raiders. I think I will go for the trade goods. Looking for one additional... Oh, why did I place my miner? Yes, diamond. Thank you, guy. Thank you, sir. So, my Dominator friends, thanks a lot for sharing the time with me, looking this episode of Let's Farm. Please don't forget to rate it. Give me some comments. When the resonance of to this video, to this Let's Farm project is very good, and I get positive feedback, I will do more videos in English, even probably with some other troop constellations or even whatever. Just talk it to me, communicate, put it down in the comment section. We'll see you soon. Your Domination Tips.